most amazing top teners, how are you doing today? I'm Rebecca Felgate, and if I ever get married, I would love to have a beautiful wedding dress. It would probably be a lie to say that most girls haven't at least thought about what they would wear on their big day, with some even fantasizing about it for years. With that in mind, I have no idea how some of the ladies on this list decided to wear what they wore on their wedding day, because, I mean, I guess you'll see. Now, a lot of these are quite sexual, and my question to the brides is, do you really want your pervy Uncle Mick gawping at your boobs and imagining what you would look like with just a little less fabric? No. No, you don't. So I'm guessing BAPs are on the menu at this wedding, as, I mean, there they are. Coming in at number 10, this is one bride who went way too low on her wedding day, and it is a rancid feast for the eyes. Even her husband is avoiding looking at them. I don't want to be rude, but the dress isn't the most flattering. It seems to be kind of sucking her boobs down rather than pushing them up. Perhaps our bride at number 10 was trying to achieve the oh-so-classy look of our number 9 bride. I mean, that dress is outright pornographic. Can you imagine going to give your nan a hug and a kiss on the cheek to thank her for coming while you were wearing that? Blimey. Arguably better, yet arguably worse, coming in at number 8, we have the much anticipated return of arm socks. Arm socks, where have you been? I don't even know what is happening here. That crown is almost bigger than the whole dress. There is a whole lot going on in one go, so it's hard to break this dress down into talking points, but if I had to, I would have some questions regarding the visible garter, the bare midriff, the outlandish bustle, and the several layers of bling. It is really nice that she decided to match her fake tan to the colour of the walls of the building she's getting married in, though. That orange glow. It's a classic. Her mother, bless her, is so happy and excited to be part of her daughter's big day that she accidentally put her bra on outside of her dress. And obviously, props to the smooth criminal groom who didn't want his wife to be the only one who got to wear white on their big day. I guess at this point, let's not even really think about these in order because they are all just as inappropriate as one another. Apart from number 1, but we'll get there. I promise it's worth it. Next up, there is nothing wrong with a pregnant bride in this day and age, but this dress is all kinds of not okay. Like A, obviously, what on earth is happening with the stomach hole, and B, why does she look so grumpy on her big day? I am all for brides showing off their baby bump, but I mean, this is taking it to a whole new, slightly uncomfortable level. Plus, won't the baby get chilly? I mean, next up at number 6, a woman who loves her veil so much she used one as her top 2. The problem is, though, is that veils are generally pretty see-through, and we can see your boobs, can't we, Brenda? This dress is so inappropriate that we've even had to blur out some genuine nuptial nips. There's a sentence I never thought I was gonna say today. Our next bride at number 5 has done us the service of covering up her nipples with, fur. I enjoy how much this bridal attire looks like an albino sarcastic fringe head shark ready to strike. I guess if you can't turn your arms into curtain rails on your wedding day, when can you? The fluff covering this lady's modesty is doing nothing other than drawing my attention to it. I'm like, there it is. That really isn't something you want pervy Uncle Mick to see, or prude Aunt Petunia. She may just strike you off the Christmas card list after she sees you in this. Some seriously bronze and seriously busting boobs up next at number 4, we have this blushing blonde bride. Or, I guess she's blushing. It's a bit hard to see under that layer of fake tan. To be honest though, nobody is even looking at her cheeks because, good lord, what a very, very, very out there rack. To be honest, this dress really doesn't look very comfortable. It's like, just squeeze them tighter. Ugh! I have no idea how she'd even sit down. Coming in at number 3, we are entering what I like to call the naked section of the video. The dresses, for want of a better word, that would have the father of the bride either passing out or pulling this face. Yep, that is a somber dad right there. But why so blue? Well, let's zoom out and see what his little girl is wearing on her special day. Oh. I think as a general rule, if your bouquet of flowers is bigger than your dress, it's probably an inappropriate wedding choice. She isn't even wearing a bra. Next up, a couple that took a leaf out of our previous bride's book. I mean, it's still classy to be semi-nude on your wedding day if you have a swan ice sculpture, right? Wrong. I love how this bride obviously spent a lot of time on her hair and makeup, but has thrown caution to the wind when it came to the dress. Although maybe she had the right idea, as I know that some brides spend hours thinking about their dress and spend thousands and thousands of pounds or dollars on them. Whereas there is nothing cheaper than your birthday suit, so have it, girl. Poor dude standing next to the swan, though. I mean, that has to be cold, which, well, you know.
I was in the pool!
So coming in at number one, I am all for celebrating femininity. I really am. But there are plenty of times to celebrate having a vagina, and I'm not sure that stitching a huge 2-foot one on your wedding dress is the way forward, because look at this monstrosity. On what otherwise could have been a lovely dress, there is now visible labia. I am sure that Auntie Sal and Grandpa Joe just didn't want to see it. Honestly, it's just too much. So that was the top 10 inappropriate wedding dresses. What would you guys want to wear on your big day? Also, if you could marry any celebrity in the world, who would it be? Let me know in the comments section down below. I think I'm gonna go for Alexander Skarsgård, so if you're watching, I promise to wear none of these dresses. I'm Rebecca Felgate, this has been Most Amazing Top 10. If you like this video, make sure you give it a good thumbs up, share it with a friend, and of course stay subscribed to Most Amazing Top 10 for more fabulous lists just like this one. And I will see you next time.